Hi, my name is Brad Lushman, and I'm one of your academic advisors in computer science at Waterloo. And today I'd like to talk about options, specializations, and minors. These have gone through some name changes over the past few years, and if you look at old calendars, it can be tricky to figure out what's going on and which of these is the thing you really want. So I'll try to explain what's really going on with all these plan components, and once I'm done, I'll also say a little bit about joint degrees. Let's start with options and specializations. Until recently, all of the designations that you could get as part of a CS degree were called options. So for example, there was the software engineering option or the AI option and so on. A couple of years ago, the university went through a process to standardize the meanings of the terms option, specialization, and minor. And in CS, we renamed our plan components to match these new definitions. So let's take a look at what those definitions are. Under the university's new definition, a specialization is something that can be attached to a specific plan, whereas an option can be attached to a variety of plans, within the same faculty. So by that definition, things like the AI option or the software engineering option or the business option and so on are more correctly termed specializations because you can attach those to a computer science degree, but you can't, for example, attach them to a CO degree. And also, by that definition, none of the things that we offered and called options were actually options. There isn't anything we offer that is actually an option. If you're interested in an example of something that is an option, you can take a look at the AI specialization, which is also available to engineering students, but on the engineering side, it is an option because it can be attached to a variety of engineering degrees, not just one, whereas the AI specialization over here, it can only be attached to computer science. All right, so that's specialization and option. A minor is meant to be widely available across campus or between faculties. So the idea with a minor is you can take it whether you're in the math faculty or if you're in another faculty. Now, partly because of these definitions and partly because of some quirks about the way the computer science program works, we actually have two computer science minors. There's the CS minor, the computer science minor, and there's the computing minor. The CS minor is a traditional sort of minor where, let me first say that the CS minor used to be made up of so-called non-specialist CS courses, those with middle digit 3, which is a little unusual because in most departments, when you do a minor, you're taking the same courses that the majors are taking, you're just taking fewer of them. But that's a problem in CS because most of our courses are restricted to the majors only. And so the computer science minor used to be this, well, take these non-specialist courses. And the problem is, like I said, it doesn't really look like most other minors look. And so we eventually decided to fix that, and so now we do have a CS minor that is made up of major level courses just fewer of them. And good, but the issue then is because our CS major level courses are restricted to CS students only, it can be a little hard to get into the CS minor. You have to, in order to do a CS minor, you have to actually enroll as a CS major, and you can stay long enough to take enough courses to get the minor, and then you can leave again. But once you are enrolled as a major, if you want, you can stay and finish the major as well. So for that reason, in order to do the CS minor, you have to go through the CS transfer process and become a CS major student, and that is a competitive process. And then you can stay as long as you like. So that's the CS minor, and it is available widely across campus in theory. It's just because of the transfer rules, it's a little bit difficult to get into. And that leaves us to where we were before, which is, well, the minor as it used to exist was widely available. And so what we did is, well, we took that minor, the so-called old CS minor, and with a few changes, basically kept it, but we called it instead the computing technology option. And for a few reasons, that got a name change very shortly after it began and became known as the computing option. But by the definition that we were given by the university, because this thing is available widely across campus, it is a minor. It should be called a minor. So we renamed it again to the computing minor, the result of which is we have two minors in computer science. The computing minor is made up of non-specialist courses. So courses where the middle digit is 3. And it does not have that competitive entry process that the CS minor has. So this is still widely available, and if that is what you're looking to do, then we can probably help you out. All right, so that's the difference between the CS minor and the computing minor, and why we have two minors and why they have to be called minors. Let me say a little bit about joint degrees. A joint is sort of more related to doing a double major. The idea is you really are interested enough in two things to want to major in both of them. So it's sort of like a double major. So you would always do joint CS along with something else. But a double major, if you're majoring in two topics that are not that related to each other, will require you to take a lot of courses and may mean that you have to be here longer than the standard 8 terms. And so a joint is sort of like saying, I'd like to do a double, but I also don't want to be here the extra time. So it's like a double, but just a few fewer courses. And for CS, that would be 3 fewer, and presumably most other joints would be similar. All right, so if you're looking to do a joint, that's what a joint means. Then there's the question of what should I do? Students come and want to know which option should I do, or should I do two options? Students have been known to come in and say, well, if I take this exact combination of courses, I can get all these options and stuff attached to my diploma. Really what you want to do is do an option if it is interesting to you. Do an option if you genuinely like what you're studying. If you have a passion for computer science combined with business, do the business option. If you don't, then don't. It's always better just to study that which makes you happy, as opposed to trying to figure out what's going to give me an advantage later on. That's a game that you can't really figure out. You never go wrong by studying the thing you want to study. So what should I do? Do an option if it's truly interesting to you. If it's not, if it turns out that what you want to do is just a plain BCS or BMath CS, it's a fine degree and there's nothing wrong with it and you should be proud of it. Do the options again if they're interesting to you. All right, hopefully that clears up some of the questions that you may have about the terminology, about all of these plan components that we can add. If you have any other questions, you can contact us at the CS Advisor email address, which is just above me, and I thank you for your time.